Good day everyone, welcome back sa Database Management System. This is the continuation of lecture number 3, Data Models. So ngunyan ang pag-restoryahan ta naman, ining business roles. Okay, so let us define first what is business role. So business role, brief, precise, and an ambiguous description of policy, procedure, or principle within a specific organization. So, yan ang business role. Description of policy, so procedure, or principle kang sarong specific na organization. Yan ang business role. Business roles derive from detailed descriptions of organization's operations. Help to create and enforce actions within that organization environment. Okay, so ang business role na, hali yan sa detailed descriptions of an organization's operations. Kasi ang sarong organization, especially business operations, igwayang ki detailed descriptions kang operations ninda. So, dawa nung business yan. Mag-school, ang business or ano pang business, igwan ang gadpirme yan ki detailed descriptions kang sa indang operations. Okay? So, business operation. Business roles must be rendered in writing. So, dapat isurat mo. And updated. Dapat ang business role mo updated. Bakong so, haluyo ng business rules. Iguana pa lang ki bagong business rule. So, dapat updated. Tanganing mag-reflect any change in the organization's operational environment. Yeah. So, dapat updated ang business role na gagamitan mo sa data modeling. So, dapat must be rendered in writing. Properly written business roles are used to define entities. So, yun ay ang pinaka-importante. Properly written business roles are used to define entities. Attributes, relationship, and constraints. So, ma-identify mo. So, entities, attributes, relationship, hali duman sa properly written na business roles. Tabata inibagang entities, attributes, relationship, and constraints. Iyo ini so basic building blocks kang data models. So, dahil kapalan makakagibo kay data model, pagdai mo aram so business roles. Kasi using the business role, you can define the entities. What are the attributes of that entities? Ano sa mga relationship among that entities? And of course, so constraint. Ayan. Anytime you see relationship statement, such as, kung nakakailing ka na kay relationship statement, such as, an agent can serve many customers and its customer can be served by only one agent. So, you are seeing business roles at work. Ayan. Okay, next. To be effective, business roles must be easy to understand. So, dapat ang business role madaling intindihon and widely disseminated so within organization to ensure that every person in the organization shares a common interpretation of the rules. Okay, so yan ang pinaka-importante. So, dapat so kada person, kada empleyado sa laog kang organization naan, dapat shares a common interpretation kang rules. Bako na, mang iba-iba ang interpretation. Okay? So, kaya nga, nasabi din, dapat must be easy to understand and widely disseminated para masiguro na kada every person in that particular organization share a common interpretation of the rules. Okay? Business role described in simple language. So, ang business role na, kay puhan i-describe sa simple language. The main and distinguishable characteristics of the data as viewed by the company. Simple language lang dapat ang gamiton sa sa business role. So kung ma-describe ka kang business role, you must use simple language. Okay? So example, this one. A customer may generate many invoices. So this is very simple. Easy to understand. Na ang customer nag-generate kida call na invoices. Diba? Kasi kung ikaw ang customer, si one customer, dako lang pigbakal niya, pwede mag-generate siya kida call na invoices. Then, an invoice is generated by only one customer. Of course. Ang particular na invoice, pigag-generate yan, kansarusan ng customer. Yeah? So, alangan man, si Juan kasi Pedro, pareho ang invoice niya. Dahil man ito pwede. Diba? So, this is very simple. Very easy to understand. Malinaw. Dawa, dahil na ipaliwanag. Maiintindihan mo sa sarong basa mo pa sana. Okay, another. A training session cannot be scheduled for fewer than 10 employees or for more than 30 employees. Another simple business rule. Na easy to understand. So, dawa, sisay ka ng makabasa, dyan sa lawkang organization naan, sigurado ako, ang interpretation ni Dakayam, para riho. Okay? Kasi very simple ang business rule. Okay, discovering business rules. Paano ito na di-discover yun sa business rules? Saan kita makuha kang business rules na, napigay para taram? Saan man ngayon, sir, kukuhaon? Naburo business rules na. Okay. The main source of business rules are company managers. Yan ang pinaka-main source, company managers. So, policy makers, department managers, and of course, written documentation. Such as, sa mga written documentation, company procedures, standards, operations manual. Kasi ang mga company, igway ang kipigapod na operation manual. Kung ang gigibuhon, mingaya sir, alimbawa, magibo kami ki-database sa enrollment system, siyempre magibo na kami ki-data model. So, kay puwan may man sa business role, so saan mo kukawang sa business role? Sa school, ang mga school baga, igwaman niyang kipigapod na sumanual linda school, school manual, so pwede mo kuhaon duman ang business role. Or pwede ka mag-interview. Interviewon mo sa registrar, interviewon mo sa presidente, interviewon mo sa dean, makakakuha ka dyan ki business rules. Okay? A faster and more direct source of business rules, it is direct interviews with end users. Yun ay ang pinakamadali. Yun ang pinakamadali. However, unfortunately, because perceptions differ, end users are sometimes less reliable. So, less reliable. Dahil mong sinabi na, bakong reliable? Less reliable lang. Anong rason nata? Less reliable ang ano ini? Ang end user. Kasi, pag-abot na sa perception. Kasi, kung end user ka, posibleng iba man sa perception mo kay itong business rules na ito, compare mo duman sa perception kang company managers so pakasabot. Diyo? Kaya least reliable siya. Although pwede mong interviewon si end user, pero sabi, least reliable. Kasi mas nakakasabot man ang God sa company managers kaysa duman sa end users. O kaya mas nakakaintindi sa policy makers compare mo sa end users. Okay, so yan ang explanation. So the process of identifying and documenting business role is essential to database design for several reasons. So yan, importante sa process of identifying and document mo sa business roles. Importante ho nun iyan sa database designs. Ano dahil sa mga rason? Help to standardize the company's view of data. So that is the first reason. Standardize, standardize the company's view of data. They can be communication tool between users and designers. Kasi ang ma-design kang data model, si designer. So communication tool kang users, buda so designers. They allow the designer to understand the nature, role, and scope of the data. Maintindihan kang designer, kang database designer, su nature, su rule, buda su scope, kang data. Di allow the designer to understand business process. Okay, so maintindihan kang designer su business process. Kasi pag mag-ibu kang data model, dapat naiintindihan mo su business process. Okay, so dahil dyan sa business role, maintindihan kang designer su business process. Di allow the designer to develop appropriate relationship, participations, rules and constraints, and to create an accurate data model. Iyan sa mga rason. So designer, maka-develop ki appropriate relationship participation rules, pati sa constraints. And then, of course, makaka-create na siya ki accurate na data model. Okay? So yan so reasons. Ngunyan, nakuha na sa business rules, hali duman sa interview, interview sa manager, interview sa policy makers, binasa pa sa users, users manual. So operation manual. So paano mo na ito itatranslate sa data model components? Hindi na naman kung paano siya. So business role, set the stage for the proper identification of entities. So, para ma-identify mo so entities, so attributes, relationship, and constraints, kaipuhan mo na sumakuha so business rules. Yeah? So, kung dahing business role, dahil mo ma-identify so entities, attributes, relationship, and constraints. Okay, sa real world, names are used to identify objects. So, para ma-identify mo ang objects, kaipuhan mo kiname. Correct. Kasi sa tao baga, para maapod mo ang sarong tao, for example, kaipuhan mo sa pangaran. Kaipuhan mo sa pangaran kay ito. Kung paano mo siya apodon. Kaday man pwedeng tumaram kang, psst, huy. Eh, kung dakul bagay yan na tao, sisang pigohoy-hoy mo. Bako. So, kaipuhan mo su name para ma-identify mo ang sarong tao. So, parehas man digdi. Ha? Digdi sa ano ta? Sa ano ini? Sa business roles kasi ita-translate niya sa data model components. So, kaipuhan tang i-identify so objects. Isang object? So, entities. So, attributes. Okay? So, kaipuhan mo yan ma-identify. So, para ma-identify mo yan, kaipuhan ta kiname. Yeah? Okay, so if the business environment wants to keep track of the objects, there will be specific business roles for them. So kung sa business environment mo yan yung i-keep track na sa object, kaipuan ki specific business roles on how to track the particular object. Okay? As a general rule, a noun in a business role will translate into an entity. Okay, so malinaw, this is very clear. Na so noun duman sa business role, ita-translate mo sa entity. Will translate into an entity in the model. And a verb, so verb da, active or passive, associating nouns, will translate into relationship among the entities. Okay, so para makuha mo so relationship among the entities, so hanapon mo duman so verb, active or passive. Para naman ma-identify mo sa entity, kaipuhan mo anapon sa noun. Duman sa business role na ito. Kasi sa noun, ita-translate mo sa entity. So, verb, active or passive, associating nouns, will translate into relationship. Okay? So, example sa business role. For example, this is the business role. A customer may generate many invoices. Okay, guaneki nouns, two nouns. So, customer and invoices. Okay, customer and invoices. So, iguayang ki verb. Ano ang verb? Generate. Iyan so nag-associate kay customer and then si invoices. So, digdi, ang magiging entity mo digdi, customer. And then, invoices. So, ang magiging relationship, generate. Yan. So, arog ka ng pag-identify. Ha? Pag-translate. Ha? Ha? Pag-translate kang business role, ita-translate mo siya sa data model components. So, gamit ang business role, i-identify mo so entity, and then so relationship. Okay. So, noun, ita-translate sa entity. So, verb, ito ang magiging relationship. Okay. From this business role, so itong business role na ito, you could conclude that, so itong previous, ining business role na ini, continuation ining next slide. So, pwede ka na mag-conclude na customer and invoice are object of interest for the environment and should be represented by their respective entities. So, yan ang object of interest. Huh? So, kaipuhan mong pangaranan itong entities na ito. Ma-identify. So, entities. So, ano so entities na? Customer and invoice. So, customer and invoice are object of interest for the environment and should be represented by, so, dapat may represent by their respective entities. Okay? So, there is a generate relationship between customer and invoice. Generate ang relationship niya. Okay. To properly identify the type of relationship, you should consider that relationship are bidirectional. Saro pa. Dapat ma-identify mo pa dyan kung anong klaseng relationship ang i-employ, ang gagamiton sa data model. Kasi baga kitang three types of relationship na pinagamit sa data model, one-to-many relationship, many-to-many relationship, one-to-one relationship. So, paano mo masasabi na ang relationship one-to-many? Paano mo masasabi na many-to-many or one-to-one relationship? How? Okay. So, dig. Sabi, you should consider that relationship are bidirectional. Bidirectional. Gusto sabi yun, from left going to the right, then right going to the left. Kasi bidirectional. Okay. So, dig sa statement. Customer may generate many invoices. Okay. Is complemented by the business role, an invoice is generated by only one customer. So, yan ang pig-apod na bidirectional. So, generate customer da. Sorry, nagkaka-birilot-bilot kita. So, customer da may generate many invoices. So, sarong customer, the cool na invoice, may generate. Pwedeng mag-generate, pwedeng din mag-generate. So, kung mag-generate man, pwedeng the cool na invoices. So, sarong customer. So, complemented yan. Kasi bidirectional eh. So, pabalik ka yan, kasi customer going to invoice eh. So, ibalik ta. Invoices naman going to customer. So, an invoice is generated by only one customer. So, which is correct. So, tama yun yung business role. Kasi sarong customer, pwedeng mag-generate kidakol na invoices. So, itong mga invoices na itong na-generate niya, para lang ito sa particular na customer. Then, man pwedeng, so, sabi ko kasi bago-baga, then, man pwede na so, invoice ni Juan, maging invoice ni Pedro. So, dahil man ito pwede. Kaya, customer may generate many invoices. An invoice is generated by only one customer. Okay. So, kung may invoice man si Pedro, iba man itong invoice niya. Iba man so kay Juan. Okay? So, in this case, ang relationship din na gagamitin mo is one-to-many relationship. So, one side duman sa customer, and duman sa invoice, many side. O, yun na yan ang gagamitin mo. One-to-many relationship between customer and invoices. Okay. As a general rule, to properly identify the relationship type, you should ask two questions. Okay, kaipuhan mo daw magapot. How many instances of B are related to one instance of A? Okay. Bidirectional. How many instances of A are related to one instance of B? Okay, so bidirectional mong baga ang hapot. Example. You can assess the relationship between student and class by asking two questions. So, halimbawa, entity student, entity class. Okay. So, paano mo i-assess ang relationship? Anong relationship type ang gagamitin mo dyan? Sa student na entity and then the class entity. So, pwede kang maghapot, kiduang hapot. How many classes can one student enroll? Ang simbag, many classes. Of course, correct. Kasi ang sarong estudyante, pwede mag-enroll kidakol na klase. English na klase, Filipino na klase, computer programming na klase. How many students can enroll in one class? Many students. Oh. So, sarong estudyante da, pwede mag-enroll kidakol na klase. How many students? How many classes can one student enroll? Oh, sarong estudyante, pero ang pwedeng enrollan na klase, ang simbag dakol. Yeah. Pero ito man na klaseng ito, ito man na klaseng ito, pero ang student duman, ang pwedeng maglaog. Ang sabi, many students. Oh, di, ang relationship niya, many to many relationship. Kasi sarong estudyante, dakol na klase. Itong klase, dakol na estudyante. Oh, di, both sides, many side. Many classes, many students. So, therefore, pwede na akong mag-conclude na ang gagamitong kong relationship type is between student and class, ang gagamitong ko is many-to-many relationship. Okay. Naming conventions. During the translation of business rules to data model components, you identify attributes, relationship, and constraints. Okay, so ito ang nangyari. So, during translation kang business rules, na-identify mo na, so, ano so entities, ano so mga attributes, so, relationship, and constraints. So, ngunyan, ano ang sunod ng gigibohon? This identification process includes, sa identification process, includes naming the object, papangaranan muna sa object na na-identify mo. Halimbawa, naka-identify ka ng mga entities. Kaipuhan muna itong pangararanan kung anong mga names kang entities na ito. Anong mga pangaran kaya ng mga entities naan? Okay? In a way that makes the object unique and distinguishable from other objects in the problem domain. Okay? Anong i-assert niya sa problem domain ta? Kung enrollment system, so ang problem domain mo, so kabilugan kang enrollment. Kung database kang enrollment ang gigibuhon mo, ang problem domain kan, so kabilugan kang enrollment. Okay? So ito ang magiging problem domain mo. So ngunyan, paano ka na mapangaran? It is important that you pay special attention to how you name the objects you are discovering. Basta sabi digdi, dapat na unique. That makes the object unique and distinguishable from objects and the problem domain. Okay. Entity name should be descriptive. Ayun. So, ang entity names ta should be descriptive. Pag sinabi mong descriptive, sa pangaran pa lang, napipicture mo na, nadidescribe mo na kung anong klaseng entity yan. O, halimbawa, sa enrollment system, so database kang enrollment, mapangaran akong entity, student. So, di ba descriptive? Automatic, aram ko na. Pag sinabi mong student, yan ang entity nga, siyempre, ang magiging laugkan, lalo sa mga attributes kan, tungkol sa estudyante. Okay? So, descriptive siya. So, kung igwa ka ng entity name na student, aday ka na pwedeng mag-create pang another entity na student pa ng pangaran. Kasi sabi baga, unique and distinguishable from other objects in the problem domain. Kasi ang problem domain ta, so enrollment system na database. Okay. So, tapos sabi pa digdi, use terminology that is familiar to the users. So, magamit kang terminology na familiar sa user. Dahil ka magamit kang terminology na not familiar to user. Okay? So, do not use terminology not familiar to the users. So, dapat familiar sa users sa terminology. Ano pa? An attribute name, okay, tingnan naman kita sa attribute, should also be descriptive of the data represented by that attribute. Saro pa yan, na importante. Pag na-identify mo na sa entity, For example, na-identify mo sa entity, a student. Ha? Kasi enrollment system na database ang i-develop ta. Okay, ano sa mga attributes ka ito? Ha? Na student na entity. Yaw na dyan sa first name, middle name, last name, address. Yun. So, kaipuhan mo itong pangaranan man. Dapat descriptive man. Ha? Kung anong data ang pinirepresent ka ito, iyo ang ipapangaran mo. So, for example, last name. O, di pangaranan mo siya last name. Kasi ang data ang pinirepresent niya, so last name kang estudyante. Address. Ang pinirepresent niya address, so ang name niya dapat address man. Descriptive. Ha? Dahil pag gibuho na address, ang ilalawag pala na data, first name. O, di ba kung descriptive? So, dapat descriptive. Okay. It is also a good practice, ha? Good practice to prefix the name of an attribute with the name of the entity. Ayun. So, good practice na, ha? Na dapat ang pangaran kang attribute mo, dapat may prefix, ha? May prefix kang pangaran kang entity. Okay? Halimbawa, on sa example, customer na entity. Okay? So, ang entity ta is customer. So, credit limit niya, customer's credit limit, pwede tang apo doon or pwede tang pangaranan na cost on sa prefix underscore credit underscore limit. Okay. So, dahil pwedeng igwa ka dyan case space, ha? Ha? Dahil yan pwede, lalo na pag nag-ibo ka ng table. Dahil yan pwede na fields na may space. Okay? So, kaipuhan, kaganan mo siyang underscore. So, cost underscore credit underscore limit. Or, cost underscore last name. Or, and cost underscore first name. Diyan, so prefix kang customer. So, madali ko siyang maintindihan. Palalo na pag nag-query ka na, nag-program na so application developer, so ano yan, application programmer, nag-program na siya. So, pag nahiling niyang may prefix na cost, ay, para ining yan sa customer na entity. O, ni naman, STO first name. O, para ini sa student na entity. Ining first name na ini. Kasi, uni baga, parehas last name. O, paano mo siya identify? O, sa pagi kang prefix, ining cost, customeran. Ining STO, student yan. Okay. So, yan so, naming conventions ta. Okay? So, sana naintindihan. Okay? So, hanggang digi naman sa nangunang topic ta. And then, hanggang sa susunod naman na video lecture. Thank you for watching and listening.